Training efficiently. To have a long-term effective training plan that burns through the fat is important. Fat metabolism range. The optimal heart rate for the fatty metabolism area to be affected by a maximum of 60 to 70% of the heart rate's capacity, according to studies. This heart rate allows for extensive long-term suitable endurance. For the maximum heart rate capacity, it will be measured. The formula for this is 220 minus your age, maximum heart rate capacity. Let's use an example for a 30-year-old man. 220, you subtract 30, which gives 190, maximum heart rate capacity. The optimal heart rate for burning fat is 60 to 70% of the maximum heart rate capacity. Therefore, 60 to 70% of 190 would be the most efficient fat burning rate for a 30-year-old man. The formula: optimal fat burning heart rate is the maximum heart rate multiplied by 0.60. Optimal fat burning heart rate is the maximum heart rate times 0.70. This means the optimal fat burning heart rate for a 30-year-old man would be between 114 and 133 beats a minute. In our example, the optimal fat burning heart rate is 190 times 0.60, which means the maximum heart rate is 114. The optimal fat burning heart rate from 190. Maximum heart rate times 0.70, which is 133. So now calculate what your optimal heart fat burning heart rate would be. This calculation is designed for hobby athletes who are dieting. If you happen to be a professional athlete or participating in an under 3-hour marathon, one needs to have the lactate levels checked as part of the heart rate equation. This is a very extensive and expensive test. It would be recommended this test only for professional athletes. For the hobby athlete, the heart rate formula is plenty. The salt in the soup. Cooking salt is taken in by the body in combination with the chemical element sodium and chloride electrolyte. Sodium permits substances to go in and out of the body cells. One finds it most often in the blood and in the fluid between the body cells. Therefore, if you consume too much salt, you'll get thirsty, and the amount of sodium in the fluid between the cells goes up. This, in turn, saturates the body cell with too much fluid. This causes an imminent inner dehydration and the blood pressure rises. To lose weight, the best thing you can do is enjoy balanced diets of foods. More plant-based over meat products. No need to eat flavorless foods. First, you can season your foods with spices and herbs. Herbs are not a neutral and will provide special flavoring. You might be surprised and find you no longer need to add salt. Foods with high salted content are prepared meats like cooked ham and salami. Timing is always important. Throughout the day, try to enjoy fruit. The sweeter fruits in the morning, as there are many sorts of fruits. An example is bananas. Banana turns into fruit sugars and fat cells fairly quickly. In the evenings, you should consume less fruit and focus more on protein-rich foods. For example, did you know one papaya only contains 13 calories for 100 grams? Melons contain 25 calories for about 100 grams. 3 strawberries contain 32 calories for 100 grams. 4 raspberries contain 33 calories for 100 grams. And 5 lemons contains only 36 calories for 100 grams. Water soluble and fat soluble vitamins. water-soluble vitamins, for example vitamin C and the B vitamins, are located in the bloodstream and in the intercellular spaces and are not stored. Fat-soluble vitamins are stored in the body. The importance of vitamins. Vitamins help in weight loss, the function of the metabolism, and the utilization of nutrients, such as carbohydrates, proteins, and minerals, water-soluble vitamins, vitamin B, thiamine. Task: nerve function, muscles and enzymes. Functions: good sources, pork, legumes, potatoes, and the outer layers of all grains. Vitamin B2, riboflavin. Task: growth, cell respiration, metabolism, and skin structure. Good sources are milk, cheese, eggs, fish, whole grain products, liver, yeast, kale, parsley, spinach, broccoli, mushrooms, potatoes, and fruit. Niacin, the task activating enzymes, cell respiration, and skin development. Good sources: peanuts, yeast, melon, peaches, dried fruit, meat, whole grains, salmon, mackerel, and mushrooms and peas. Vitamin B6, pyridoxine. Task: metabolizing proteins and activating enzymes. Good sources: whole grains, potatoes, chicken, pork, and fish. Folic acid. Task: metabolizing proteins. It is essential, as there is vitamin B12 present, for the folic acid to be properly absorbed. Good sources: whole grains, vegetables, salads, dairy products, wheat germ, and soya beans. Vitamin B12, cyclobalamin. Task: metabolizing protein and blood building. Good sources: liver, meat, eggs, milk, cheese, sauerkraut, and yeast. Biotin. Task: enzyme activating protein, metabolizes carbohydrates and fat. Good sources: liver, egg yolk, nuts, soya beans, rice, and grains. Pantothenic. Task: enzyme activation, plays a central role in metabolizing energy and fatty acids. Good sources: legumes, meat, fish, milk, and whole grains. Vitamin C has its task: it strengthens the immune system involved in the detoxification process, improves iron supply. Good sources: peppers, kiwi and sea buckthorn, black currants, citrus fruits, rose hips, and gooseberries. Fat soluble vitamins. Vitamin A, retinol. Task: vision, structure and function of mucosal epithelia, synthesis of mucopolysaccharides, and growth. Good sources: spinach, lettuce, mushrooms, fish oil, liver, and provitamins, B carotene in yellow vegetables. Vitamin D, cholecalciferol. Task: regulation of calcium and phosphate metabolism, protein against demineralization and the bone. Good sources: fish, liver oil, cod liver oil, liver and egg yolk. Vitamin E, tocopherol. Task: antioxidant, effect membrane stabilization. Good sources: sunflower oil, olive oil, nuts, eggs, vegetable oil, particularly wheat germ. Vitamin K, phylloquinone. Task: synthesis of various coagulation factors. Good sources: meat, fish, egg, milk, cabbage, and tomatoes. Minerals and trace elements. For you to lose weight, these are the most important minerals. Minerals must be supplied to the body with food. Some are building minerals for bones and teeth, while others responsible for your water resources, as well as muscle and nerve function. Many minerals, components like enzymes, affect your metabolic processes. Among the most important minerals include sodium, potassium, phosphorus, calcium, magnesium, and of course, chlorine. Trace elements. Trace elements are substances that are found only in small amounts throughout the body. These include chromium, copper, fluorine, manganese, iodine, selenium, and zinc.